Welcome to this video on how to build an SD card with a TI Processors Linux SDK. This is a quick agenda of what we'll be seeing here. What is the SD card and why do we need it? What you need to build an SD card, building the SD card, and then finally testing the SD card. Most TI EVMs or evaluation modules have an SD card in the processor boot order, like the one shown here in this slide. The SD card will hold the boot images and a supporting file system for that board. While this video is about the Linux use case, the SD card can hold either a TI Linux SDK ecosystem or a TI SDK RTOS ecosystem. This video is about creating an SD card using the processor TI Linux SDK. Each SDK release has a script that can be used to create an SD card containing the released or pre-built images for U-boot and the kernel and file system. The building process will partition the SD card into at least two partitions and then copy the necessary images into each partition. After the script is run and the SD card has been partitioned and imaged, the SD card can be inserted into the SD card slot on the EVM and the board can be powered and booted. One nice thing from an out-of-box perspective is that all the TI EVMs for a processor class, such as the AM57, can use the same SD card for both the AM57 GPU EVM and the AM57X IDK board. The SD card holds the software necessary to boot the board. In the case of Linux, it's going to hold MLO, U-boot, the Linux kernel, and the root file system necessary to boot the board. The pre-built images provided with the SDK provides the out-of-box demonstration and an experimentation platform and a product development kickoff platform. The picture at right is showing an example micro SD card for the BeagleBone Black. This will be used as the example for this video. What you will need to build an SD card. The picture at right more or less sums it up. You're going to need a USB SD card reader. You will also need a SD card, either new or not, will not matter. And you'll need the TI Processor Linux SDK installed on a PC running Linux. As you can see, this is a former Windows machine that is running Linux, and that's what we use to set up and run this SD card script with. Okay, so now we're going to move on to actually building the SD card. So therefore, insert the card into the USB reader as shown in the picture at right, and then the picture on the bottom is showing the USB card reader actually plugged into a Linux host machine. This is now where we'll switch over to some live action shots showing the script that's running to build the SD card. Okay, so switching to the desktop now, we're going to open up a terminal window. We're going to maximize it, and then we're going to switch into the directory where we've installed the Texas Instruments Processors Linux SDK. We're also switching to the bin directory. And once in this directory, we're going to list the contents of this directory, and we're looking for a file called createSDCard.sh. This script is what will be used to program the SD card with. Okay, now we're going to insert the SD card through the USB reader, and you can see here the Linux laptop has detected the card has been read in. You will also see that it's a 32 gig card, and for right now we can just minimize this window. All right, so now we're going to run the script, and we have to run the script as sudo. So we do the .slash create sdcard.sh, hit enter, and we enter our sudo password. The script starts to run, and you'll see it has detected one slot or one card at device number one. Okay, so now we will select one, and it will start to run the rest of the script. Oh, now we hit a warning. This warning is meant to serve as a reminder that anything greater than 16 gigabytes could be your actual hard drive on your Linux machine. So this is kind of a warning to make sure you know which device you're programming. In this case, we're using SDBeat, which is the second device on this laptop that I happen to know. Okay, so now that we've made sure that the device we're programming is not the root file system of our Linux machine, we're going to select Yes to continue on. And now we get a choice of how many partitions we want to put on the SD card. As you can see in the text, it's describing you there's the option for 2 and 3. Most users, and I would say just about all users, probably just want to be doing two partitions, which will be a boot and a root FS partition. So now we'll select 2, and we'll start the process for making two partitions on the SD card. As you can see, the MakeFS and the partition information is being printed out, and you can see that this is going to take a while, so we're going to abbreviate this actual process here. So now the partitioning is done, and we have another option here to actually exit the script if we wanted. I must point out that there is really nothing on the SD card at this point other than two partitions, one for the boot partition and the other one for the root FS. Okay, so we will now enter yes to continue on. And now you see we're given another option about either selecting to install the pre-built images from the SDK or another set of images that we've built independently. Since this video is about building an SD card so we can do the out-of-box, we're going to select number one. Okay, selecting one, we'll now actually start the copying process for the images to the SD card. This is going to take a really long time as that text is highlighted there. And you can see MLO's copied, U-Boot's copied, and now we're starting the rootfs system partition copy. So this will take a while. Could be several, 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes, depending upon how fast your USB card reader works. Okay, so after the writing is complete, then the syncing process has to take place, which is basically flushing all the information to the SD card. This too can take a long time. Okay, so now when you see the operation finished, that means that the card has now been copied or imaged, and we can scroll over and take a look at the two USB sticks on there on the side, and we can select each one, and you can look at the boot partition, and you can look at also the root partition or rootfs partition to make sure everything is there. You're mostly just making sure that there's directories showing up in both partitions. This is just a really cursory quick check. Okay, after checking, it's time to unmount the drives. So looking in the window there, you can select both the boot or the rootfs and just kind of, you see they're selected, so they'll unmount these particular drives. And now you can take the USB card reader out of the PC and it's ready to go. Okay, now that we've finished programming or imaging the card, we're going to install and use the SD card. The picture at right is showing the BeagleBone Black with the micro SD card inserted. We'll now power it up and show the boot process. Okay, so we're going to switch back to our terminal window and we're going to bring up Minicom. In this particular case, I'm hooked up to a BeagleBone Black on TTY USB 0. I put the SD card into the board and I hit the reset button, and now we're going to watch the boot. And after so many seconds, you will see that it was a successful boot. Here are several links where more information can be obtained. The first set is the Processor SDK documentation. The next block is a Processor SDK training series. The last set is concerning the link to the EDUI forums where questions can be posted by customers to get answers from TI experts. Please note there is a specific link that points to the Processor SDK Linux Create SD card script. This is a direct link to the wiki page that goes into more detail about how the SD card create script works and how it can be used.